listening to you. And the very first was that, you know, you said that, you know, we should not repeat the mistakes that the United States and several other Western countries did. India did not have an industrial revolution, but we already arrived at the information revolution. So we skipped some stages of this. But when it comes to urbanization, we are not skipping those stages where you committed mistakes. We want to repeat those stages, commit the same mistakes, and probably, you know, suffer more because we are more people. So the first learning is that we must really skip those stages and come to a level where we can really transform our existing cities into cities of the future. And therefore, when you defined transit-oriented development as basically pedestrian-oriented development, you know, it's a remarkable thought. And in some ways, it's a Gandhian thought. And I'll tell you why. You know, you said that put the needs of daily life within walking distance and make the walk delightful. So beautifully said. So travel long distances should be rare, and it should not be for your daily needs, either work needs or other needs. You also said it's not sustainable if it's not beautiful. Human brain never tires of beauty. It's a profound thought. So the cities of the future have to be cities that celebrate beauty and bring beauty within the experience, daily experience of every human being. Because every human being needs not just roti, kapda, makan. That's, you know, roti, kapda, makan. Roti is bread, kapda is this, and makan is a roof over your head. Man doesn't need only that. Man needs beauty. You know, Dostoevsky's that statement, beauty will save the world. Beauty will save the world. It's very, very profound. And therefore, we have to create cities of the future which are beautiful. And why I said it is Gandhian is, you know, Gandhi is regarded by many people as anti-modernity. He was not in favor of industrialization. At some point, you know, he even opposed railways. You know, in his Hind Swaraj that he wrote in 1909, he opposed railways. And, you know, he was made the target of so much criticism. Of course, as far as railway is concerned, he revised his opinion. But I want to tell you why he opposed railways. And he says, that the visible symbols of modern civilization, the railway and the motor car. One reason why he opposed railways was because the British who built the railways did it for their own purposes, you know, for their colonial consolidation. But there was also a philosophical reason. And he says, Gandhi was critical of the modern man's craze for fast and unnecessary mobility. Gandhi was critical of the modern man's craze for fast and unnecessary mobility, which he believed made man pay less attention to his inner self. Fast mobility made man pay less attention to his inner self. And then I'm quoting him, speed is not the end of life. He says, speed is not the end of life. Man sees more and lives more truly by walking to his duty. Man sees more and man lives more truly by walking to his duty. He wrote in Harijan of 30 September 1939. So he says that walking is a spiritual activity. Walking is a spiritual activity. So when you said that transit-oriented development is actually pedestrian-oriented, walking-oriented development, the cities that we have to envision and create are cities where all our daily needs, as much as possible, are within walking distance. And here I believe, you know, as you pointed out so well, technology is our greatest ally. So Lina, it's not, technology enablement is absolutely necessary, and it is necessary in every which way. So technology enablement will help us share our resources, you know, which is what is actually happening, the new ways of sharing mobility. So sharing economy is not just sharing automobiles, sharing infrastructure, it is also sharing space, which belongs to all. So it's a wonderful talk that we heard. You know, we have enormous problems. In some ways, you know, the West is beginning to rectify its own mistakes. So we should not commit these mistakes. Learn from each other and find ways by which we can have more and more such conversations. Lastly, you know, if it was only for eating biscuits, you know, we would provide as many biscuits as much possible. The fact is that they don't even come for these lectures. You invite these government officials, they don't even come, but they take all the decisions. That's the tragedy. They don't talk to each other, but they also don't, you know, they rarely talk to experts outside. Go to whom? Yeah, we should go more and more.
Lastly, it's a very famous, profound thought. You know, those who walk, they don't take decisions. And those who take decisions rarely walk. Thank you very much.
So, thank you. I would like to formally thank Jeffrey Tumlin for the talk, and I would also like to formally thank Romy Roy at Delhi Development Authority, and we should be having her over in January or Feb. I think she'll be speaking to us about the Kakaduma TOD, and I hope all of you will be there, and we'll have many more people. And so thank you to all of you also for coming over on a almost holiday season. Thank you, everybody.
And before Romy comes, I would urge you to look at the Delhi Development Authority's TOD policy, which is one of the smartest TOD policies that I've seen anywhere in the world, and is very particularly tailored to the Delhi environment. I had a great time arguing with Romy about it until she convinced me that hers was actually a lot smarter than the other ones that I was promoting.
And interestingly, in 2012, August of 2012, in the same room, we've had a very good day-long discussion on improving the pedestrian walking infrastructure in the city. A little bit earlier than that, in June 2012, I was a co-founder in a project called Walking Project. And we unfortunately went a bit too slow in that, and we are reviving that all over again. So hopefully we'll have all of you as active supporters of Walking Project as well. Thank you.